Harinam Sankirtan Kira, Nitai Gaur Premananda. All glories to assembled devotees. All glories to assembled devotees. All glories to assembled devotees. Jai Shri Prabhupada. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Narayanam Namaskritya. Naram Chaiva Narottamam. Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam. Tato Jayam Udiraye. Nashtapraeshvabhadreshu. Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya. Bhagavati Uttama Shloke. Bhaktir Bhavati Naishtiki. Hare Krishna. So reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 11, Chapter 10, The Nature of Fruitive Activity, Text 10. Yo asa guner vicharito dehoyam purushasya hi samsarastad nibandhoyam punso vidya chit atmana. Yo asa guner virachito dehoyam purushasya hi samsarastad nibandhoyam punsa vidya chitatmana. Yo asa guner virachito dehoyam purushasya hi samsarastad nibandhoyam punso vidya chidatmana. Mataji's
Mataji's
Yaha. Kindly repeat. Yaha. Which. Asau. That. Subtle body. Gunang. By the material modes. Virachita. Constructed. Deha. The body. Ayam. This. Cross body. Purushasya. Of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He. Certainly. Samsara. Material existence. Tat Nibandha. Tied to that. Ayam. This. Punsa. Of the living entity. Vidya. Knowledge. Chit. That which cuts apart. Atmana. Of the soul. Translation and purport by the disciples of His Divine Grace, S.A. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Translation. The subtle and gross material bodies are created by the material modes of nature, which expand from the potency of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Material existence occurs when the living entity falsely accepts the qualities of the gross and subtle bodies as being his own factual nature. This illusory state, however, can be destroyed by real knowledge. Purport. Regarding the analogy comparing the fire and its fuel to the soul and the body, one may argue that to some extent fire is dependent upon its fuel and cannot exist without it. Since we do not experience the existence of fire independent of fuel, one may therefore still question how it is possible for the living entity to exist separately from the body, become covered by it, and eventually become free from it. Only through the Supreme Personality of Godhead's knowledge potency, Vidya, can one clearly understand the nature of the living entity. By Vidya, or real knowledge, one may cut material existence to pieces and even in this lifetime experience spiritual reality. According to Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, our material existence is an artificial imposition. By the Lord's inconceivable potency of nescience, the qualities of gross and subtle material forms are psychologically imposed upon the living being. And because of misidentification with the body, the living entity initiates a series of illusory activities. As explained in the previous chapter, the present material body is like a tree that produces the karmic seed of the next body. However, this cycle of ignorance can be cut to pieces by the transcendental knowledge explained by the Lord. Unfortunately, the conditioned souls, being inimical to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, do not accept the perfect knowledge spoken by the Lord. Instead, they remain absorbed in gross and subtle illusion. But if the living entity accepts the Lord's knowledge, his whole situation can be rectified and he can return to his original, eternal, blissful life of perfect knowledge in the direct association of the Lord. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitana Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam Namaum Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishnaya Krishna Chaitanya Namane Gauratvishe Namaha He Krishna Karuna Sindho Dina Bandho Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostate Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Krupa Sindho Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna So in this verse Lord Krishna is instructing Uddhava. He is giving the knowledge of this material world, the knowledge of the soul's entanglement in this material world, and how this soul can liberate himself from this cycle of birth and death. And in this verse especially, Lord is explaining about the gross and subtle material bodies which the soul has acquired in this material world. And how one can become free from that? This is a process Lord Krishna is giving. Is it audible to everyone behind? Everyone is able to hear? Is it audible? Okay. So, sometimes or most of the time in the material world there is huge identity crisis. People are unaware of their original identity. And in this material world, everyone has been given this material body, gross body and a subtle body. It's a very precarious condition in which the soul has been put. It is like the prison house. one has been put in the prison house. And one cannot come out of it easily. One doesn't know the process by which to come out of it. And one is thinking that, yes, I am this material body and I should maintain, I should try to expand and try to be happy in this material world. And that is the greatest illusion. And because of that, the soul is suffering in this material world, life after life, because of the false identification with this material body. And the whole world is going on like that, thinking that maybe sometime in the future I'll become happy, or we'll try to discover something by which we'll be able to live eternally, we'll not get disease, we'll not become old. And that type of desire, not to die, not to become old, or not to become diseased, that is the nature of the soul. Soul is Satchidanand, eternal, full of knowledge, full of bliss. Soul doesn't die. Soul doesn't become diseased or old. The body may undergo many changes, but the soul is eternal, it is same. So that kind of knowledge is not given in this material world. Srila Prabhupada, when he went to America, in a very famous university, MIT, he saw that there are so many different varieties of departments. Science, physics, mechanical, mechanics, chemistry, and so many departments are there. They give so much knowledge about this material world. Srila Prabhupada asked, where is the department that teaches the difference between body and soul? That knowledge is not being given. And because of that, that kind of ignorance, whatever we may try in this material world, we will not become really happy. There may be some temporary happiness for some time, but ultimately that will just slip away. Because the happiness of this material world is not eternal. The eternal soul cannot become happy with the temporary sense objects. It just not possible. It is incompatible situation. And why this is happening? Why this false identification is so strong? That has been explained in the Srimad Bhagavatam, in the earlier cantos, in the third canto, when Vidura was asking questions to Maitreya Muni about the creation. In fact, it is little interesting, because here Lord is instructing Uddhava, the knowledger, the soul and material world. So much knowledge Lord Krishna is giving. Uddhava Gita, it is known as. And if we go back little behind in the third canto, we'll see that Uddhava, he had met Maitra Muni and Vidura. Vidura was there. And Vidura was quite curious to know about the knowledge aspect of the Supreme Lord. And he was inquiring from Uddhava that, please tell me about Supreme Lord. I want to understand the nature of this material world. What is our real identity and how we can become free from cycle of birth and death. So Uddhava at that time, he explained Lord Krishna's childhood activities, how Lord is so merciful. Lord kill so many demons and especially Putana, and gave even liberation to Putana. And then Lord Krishna performed so many wonderful activities in Vrindavan. And then after that, when Vidura was inquiring more and more, he said, now I cannot tell. Now I had to go to Badrikashram. Lord had instructed me to go to Badrikashram and remain there, take sannyas. So now he was not interested in the knowledge aspect of the Lord. He just explained about Krishna's Vrindavan pastimes. I think little bit about Dwarka pastimes also. And then he stopped there. Because he had attained a different level of understanding about Lord Krishna. Now he was not so much interested in giving knowledge, how Krishna is supreme. He had already achieved a higher test. So he told that it would be Maryada Vyatikram if I talk in presence of Maitreya Muni. When Maitreya Muni is present before me, I should not be giving instructions or even giving knowledge. That is finer Vaishnava etiquette. And when superior is present, then junior should not preach. He should allow the senior to give the knowledge, explain, solve the queries. So Uddhava observed that. He considered that I am junior. Maitreya Muni is senior to me. He is more knowledgeable. And he should give the guidance. And in fact, Vidura was younger. Right? Vidura was younger to Uddhava. Vidura was elder. Vidura was elder to Uddhava. And still, Vidura considered Uddhava to be a knowledgeable person who has received the mercy of the Supreme Lord. He did not think that he is younger to me and how can I take knowledge from him. So, on the higher level, when person has more realized knowledge, more advanced in the spiritual understanding, then the material age does not matter. He may be younger to us. But if he is having that higher understanding, one should take knowledge from such personality. So in that way, Uddhava leaves and he tells Maitreya Muni to give the knowledge. And Maitra Muni, he starts explaining about the creation, Brahma's creation. And he explains that when in the beginning, Brahma, he was given a task to populate this universe. So much big responsibility. He was alone in this entire universe. He performed a lot of tapasya. And the Supreme Lord gave instructions from within, within his heart. Tene Brahma Rudaya Adhikavaye. So Brahma received that instruction and he performed tapasya. And he got the knowledge of how to create secondary creation, different species of life, how they can live happily in the material world. And he created five kinds of ignorance. Because without that, the living entity cannot become happy in this material world. Unless he forgets his real identity. When somebody forgets his eternal identity and falsely identifies in this material world, then only he can be happy in the material world. If he gets the real knowledge that I am eternal and this material world is temporary, and the happiness in this material world is all chapala sukh, then that soul cannot become happy. It is just not possible. But when someone forgets that he is eternal soul, he is full of knowledge, full of bliss, then only one can be happy in the material world. So therefore, Lord Brahma, he created five kinds of ignorance, and these are tama. One type of ignorance is tama, means one forgets his eternal identity. And because of forgetfulness, then another ignorance comes. That is fear of death. Because I am this material body, one knows that it is not going to be eternal. And I am going to die sometime. So that kind of fear of death comes. Then the bodily identification, moha. One starts identifying. First of all, one forgets who is. Then one identifies with the body. Then one thinks that one has a false sense of ownership. Everything belongs to me. Or we try to acquire so many things which ultimately we cannot take away with us. We have to just leave it here. Whatever gross and subtle identifications which we may acquire. At one time one has to give it up. That is very painful. But under illusion one thinks that I can hold on for some more time. Let me just try some more years, some more days, and one keeps moving forward in the material world. But he cannot be happy like that. And when that kind of things are taken away, then one becomes angry and frustrated. So that is called as tamisra. Is anger after frustration. One is frustrated and then becomes one becomes angry. So in this way, moha, maha moha, tamisra, andhata misra, tamas, this kind of five ignorance Brahmaji creates. And living entity is covered by this kind of ignorance. It is there in third canto, Srimad Bhagavatam, chapter 12, verse 2. So that is the condition in this material world. Whether one is a human being or animal, aquatics, birds, reptiles, or any kind of species we may take, trees, aquatics, that false identification is so strong. Srila Prabhupada also explains that when soul gets the body of a dog, it will bark. Because it is so much covered over that soul thinks that I am the dog. And if somebody comes in my area, I need to bark. So, whether one is dog or elephant or tree or any kind of species, that false identification is very strong. So the human form of life is very important. Because in this human form of life, one can understand one's eternal identity. At least one should try to acquire that knowledge. Who we are, first of all. What is our identity? And that kind of knowledge has been given by Lord Krishna in Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna gives knowledge to Arjuna. Arjuna's condition, if you see in the beginning, when Arjuna was about to fight, he had prepared, both the armies had prepared and they had organized there all the armies on the battlefield and they were standing in front of each other. So much preparation, so many days, and all the armies were gathered. So that time, Arjuna, he gets bewildered. He hesitates to fight. And in fact, looking at that huge army, ocean of army, for some time he becomes bewildered and starts thinking again, what I'm doing. And he starts telling Krishna that, oh, I don't want to fight. This is so difficult situation I have been put. That I have to kill all these teachers and brothers and worshipable gurus, and how can I kill them? And it will incur sin, and Varnasankar, and so many problems he was envisaging. So at that time, he just gives up his Gandiva bow. He was very strong, he was very powerful, he had won many battles previously. But at that time, he comes into dilemma and he is ready to give up. So Krishna understands that this is the situation. And Krishna was not speaking anything, because he allowed him to speak, first of all. Let him speak whatever he wants to speak. And he was telling, this will happen, that will happen, and so many things he was telling. Because his mind had created some kind of thoughts around him. He had forgotten his eternal identity. And we know how mind can play tricks with us. It may be a very small something, and just mind starts putting fuel, and just it starts increasing and increasing. And one thing, oh, what will happen if this happens and that happens, and if this will happen, then what will happen to me? And then so many things, mind just starts creating huge illusion. Therefore, it is said that empty minds is devil's workshop. You keep mind idle, empty, it will start bringing all the fearful thoughts, negative thoughts, and although one may be powerful and one will forget that he has so much knowledge and he can accomplish so many things, he has achieved so many things, one starts forgetting. So therefore, Lord Krishna had to give that knowledge in Bhagavad Gita. And if Bhagavad Gita somebody studies systematically, then one will understand that how Lord Krishna, he very carefully removed Arjuna's doubts. And first of all, he told that you are not this material body. You are spirit soul. That was the first lesson. You are lamenting for this material body. But you are not that. Ashochananashochastam. You are lamenting for which is not worthy of lamenting. This gross body is how much time it is going to last. For some time it was not there. It came into existing at some time. It is being maintained. It is going through changes, and at some time it will vanish. But you are not this body. You are eternal. And that eternal soul is never destroyed. Antavanta ime deha nityasya sharir. Nityasya yukta sharir. That this mortal body is antavanta. But the dehi, one who is residing in this body, is eternal. So that type of knowledge is, Lord Krishna tells that this is Guhya Gyan. This is confidential knowledge. That you are eternal. It's a great knowledge. If somebody deeply understands what knowledge Lord Krishna is giving, one will think that yes, this is what is needed actually. Because otherwise the mind will create so many hallucination around the soul, and although problem may be very simple, but just because of that it just bloated up. One thing that it's too much. I cannot handle. And therefore in today's world, so many problems are there because of the mind. Psychosomatic problems and so many issues, depression and hundreds of problems. Just because they are thinking that this material body is all in all. And I'm going to lose, or I'm going to win, or whether I'll be able to handle this failure or fame or name and so many things. Students also, we can see now 10th results and 12th results are coming, and we can see a little bit less marks, and just they try to end their lives. It is so sad. so sad to hear such kind of things, that children even at that age, they go through so much of depression and failure, they can't handle that. So therefore this knowledge is very, very important, that we are not these mortal bodies, we are eternal spirit souls. That is a confidential knowledge Lord Krishna is trying to give. And if someone can understand this knowledge, sometimes we may say, Dehe no smin yathva dehe kaumaram yavanam jaya. That is our favorite verse. Dhira satranam uyati, the eternal soul is going through so many phases of life. But when we actually go through those phases, sometimes still we may become bewildered. Oh, I'm becoming old. What will happen in old age? Whether Lord Krishna will provide me, protect me. So our faith sometimes may get tested at different times. And therefore one has to strengthen one's faith by performing devotional service. Therefore Lord Krishna keeps increasing the level of knowledge he is giving. First he gives confidential knowledge, knowledge of the soul. In the second and third chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna gives the knowledge of the soul, which is called as confidential knowledge. Then in the seventh and eighth chapter, Lord Krishna gives more confidential knowledge. Guhya, guhyatara, more confidential knowledge to perform devotional service, which will liberate one from the cycle of birth and death. And chapter 9, Krishna begins with idam tute guhyatamam, guhyatamam. Now I'm giving most confidential knowledge. I give confidential knowledge. I give more confidential knowledge. Now I'm giving guhyatama, most confidential knowledge. And what will happen? Yajnatva moksesya ashubhaya. You'll be freed, you'll be relieved from the miseries of this material existence. Lord Krishna himself is speaking. Idam tute guhyatamam pravakshami anasuyave. Kyana vidnyana setam yajnatva moksesya ashubhaya. Raja vidya raja guhyam pavitram idam uttamam. It's a very, very purified knowledge. It is a king of knowledge. Lord Krishna is telling, he is giving the most confidential knowledge. And what is that knowledge? Lord Krishna explains that it is manmana bhava madbhakto madhyaji mam namasko. The process of devotional service, pure unalloyed devotional service. Lord Krishna gave that in the very beginning. That is someone, okay, I am the not this mortal body, I am spirit soul. Then Lord Krishna gives knowledge about himself, he is the super soul. And then perform bhakti, devotional service. So bhakta, bhagwan, bhakti. Lord Krishna gives that knowledge. And he tells that this is the most confidential knowledge. And all these three things are eternal. Bhakta is eternal. Bhagwan is eternal. And the process is also eternal. So therefore, when somebody engages in devotional service, pure devotional service, it is not on the material platform. It is on a different level, it's on the spiritual platform. which is eternal. And therefore, when somebody is performing bhakti, devotional service, then he doesn't have fear of death. Or at least when somebody is chanting, Srila Prabhupada explains that this chanting will take one to the transcendental platform, on the spiritual platform. It will transcend all the physical, mental, intellectual levels and take one to the spiritual level, the highest level it will take, at least for that time, as long as we are chanting, we will be on a different platform. Although thoughts may come, so many thoughts may come, and we may, mind will take here and there, but still if somebody attempts to chant attentively, we can see that in the beginning when we came to Krishna consciousness, somebody explained the process, the chanting. What was our enthusiasm? We were greatly eager to chant, to try to understand that higher level of consciousness. But of course, our mind takes it, brings it down. Mind will again, even while chanting, mind will start disturbing. Mind will start finding faults with others. So why is chanting like that? Even while chanting, therefore the greatest attack of Maya can come within chanting. One should be very careful. If one is not careful in chanting, all that time one may start planning so many things. Okay, this devotee is doing this and he is against me. And so many things, mind will just try to divert our attention from the holy name. And instead of becoming constructive, we may become more destructive. So therefore, one has to be very carefully guard against various kinds of anarthas, which may hinder our devotional service. And therefore, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur explains that the demons killed by Lord Krishna in his childhood, they represent various anarthas within our heart. There are many, many anarthas within our heart. And it may take many lifetimes sometimes. We should not think that, okay, this life is my last life, and next life, I'll be in Golok Vrindavan. We should not think it like that. Because if we don't complete the process, we may have to come back again. If we take it up seriously, then only Krishna will take us seriously. Otherwise, we'll just become Haribol devotees. Or sometimes devotees don't want Krishna's special mercy. Krishna's mercy is okay. Yes, Krishna should be merciful to me. He supplies everything. He gives everything whatever we ask. But if he asks, do you want Krishna's special mercy? Our answer will be, no. I don't want Krishna's special mercy. Let Krishna be merciful to me. Because if Krishna becomes specially merciful, then what does he do? He starts taking away. Krishna is giving, oh, this is nice, I got so many things. Gifts, that, and everything is increasing, economy development, and position, and everything. But Krishna takes away, then one becomes very disturbed. But whatever condition, Krishna may take away, he may give, one should remain stable, one should not get disturbed. One has to attain that equilibrium of the mind, equanimity. And try to focus on serving the Lord. Because at that time, at that moment only, we have achieved Krishna consciousness. It is not that something in the future it will happen, and at that very moment, as soon as we become more attentive to our chanting, our devotional services, at that very moment we can see that there is something higher. So therefore, when we absorb more in the devotional service, we will derive the higher taste. The material mind may try to take away from various things, and it will create so many illusions, because that is a job of the mind. The gross body, we can understand that it is made up of pancha mahabhutas, but a subtle body is quite difficult to understand. Where the mind has come in picture, and we may think that I am doing devotional service, I am following everything, but suddenly mind takes over. So one has to be very careful not to get affected by this subtle body. And when one absorbs more into the chanting of the holy name, performing devotional service, serving the devotees, then one will remain on the higher platform. And Srila Prabhupada has given us that process. He has given that knowledge in the form of books, Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam. Otherwise it would have been so difficult to understand. And in Bhagavad Gita also, later on in the 18th chapter, Lord Krishna tells that idam jnanam akhyatam guhyat guhyataram maya vimrushet asheshena yathechasi tatha kuru. Krishna gave that knowledge, transcended the most confidential knowledge he gave. But still he is not attached to Arjuna that whether he will follow or not. He says that yathechasi tatha kuru. He is not forcing upon him. And again, manmana bhava madbhakto madhyaji maam namaskuru. Maam evishi satyante pratijani priyosime. This verse has come twice. 9th chapter, 34 verse, and 18th chapter, 65. Double almost. You can see double. 9, 8, 9, 18, 9, 34, 65. So, of course, I'm not trying to get into that numerology of Bhagavad Gita, but it's a coincidence. Otherwise, somebody may think that there is some numerology in Bhagavad Gita and try to take out so many meanings. But Krishna is telling that this is the most confidential knowledge. So therefore, so much emphasis has been given. So therefore, if we practice this process, then by the grace of the Lord, that illusion will be removed. And the more we continue taking shelter of the Lord, Lord will clear the path and so many obstacles on the path. Hare Krishna. Anybody has any questions, comments? They're happy. Class is over. Yes.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Guruji, these five type of ignorances, na, that tam, moha, maha, moha, tamisra, and the tamisra, please explain once more.
I think Lord Brahma, he created these five kinds of ignorance. Maitreya Muni is explaining to Vidura, and these five kinds of ignorance are created so that the eternal soul can identify with the body, material, various 84 lakh species, and try to be happy in the material world. And the first is tamma, self-deception. He forgets his own identity. Then he gets his body, material body. He thinks that I am body. That is called as moha. It's an illusion. Are we the body? Is it true? Or who we are actually? This body is changing continuously. It's going through phases, and at some time it's going to die. That body is not going to remain eternal. But we are so attached to it, decorating, and so many things we are doing, try to maintain that it doesn't become disease. So that bodily identification, that bodily conception is called as moha. Then false ownership, sense of false ownership. I own things in this material world, which is again false. Ishopanishad Lord explains that Ishavasha idam sarvam yatkincha jagatyam jagat tena tyaktena bhunjita magrida kasya siddhana. That ultimately, if we analyze, is this belongs to me? Is this belongs to me? Is everything belongs to me? The answer will be ultimately no. But we think that, okay, for temporarily it is in my possession, so it is mine. Okay. Temporarily it has been given, but is it permanently going to remain with you? Nothing will remain with us permanently. Everything will be taken away. And by the force of time, everything will be taken away from us. So therefore, that false sense of ownership is called as Mahamoha. Then because we have identified with this material body, and we know that it is going to die. We know that it is going to die at some time. We are trying to avoid death. Who wants to die? Nobody wants to die. Brahmacharis also don't want to die. Of course, they want to serve the Lord. They can more serve. Some benediction was given that jivo or marova. Brahmachari can, jivo or marova, it doesn't make any difference. He is already serving the Supreme Lord. But if you are attached, we'll think that, oh, okay, I know I am going to die, but still let me do some more service or let me accomplish something. But death can come at any moment. So therefore, that sense of death is called as Andhatamishra. And anger after frustration, we may try to fulfill so many desires, and not all desires will be fulfilled. So therefore, Kamat Krodho Vijayate, that when the desire is not fulfilled, then what happens? Krodho Vijayate, like again the anger arises. I wanted to achieve something, I wanted to get into IIT, or I mean, so many expectations, I just missed, frustration, or somebody else excel, that also causes more anger to us. Oh, I got this many marks, but he got two more marks more than me, whatever, like, or salary is more, his salary is more. So many comparisons, and we just get distracted. And therefore, that anger arises because of the frustration. That is called as tamisra. So therefore, One is put into these five kinds of ignorance, agyan, adhyana vrittaya, it is explained. That the soul has been put into this kind of, the entire mortal world is like that. Everyone is put into that condition, except the liberated souls. They come sometimes and not get affected by anything. They come, they perform their mission and then they go. They come to help us come out of ignorance. Jiva jago, jiva jago. Gaurav Chandra bole, Lord Gauranga came for that. To give the highest mercy. That so many lifetimes we have wasted. Now at least chant the holy name. Take the process. It's so easy. Yesterday Shivram Prabhu was within his heart. In the core of his heart was studying. Chanting is so simple. Krishna is so merciful. He is giving a simple process. And he recommended also a certain time. Morning 4 to 8. Of course, he has his different mood. But if we practice the process, at least we should know theoretically that Lord has brought us to this process. Krishna consciousness process he has given us. That means Lord has heard some prayer and he has guided, okay, chalo bhai tum jao idhar mandir mein aur kuch bhakton se suno, prasad lo, jap karo, seva karo, bhakti karo, chant, take prasad. At least we know that there is something higher. Guru Krishna prasad hai, paaye bhakti lata abhish. So, by the mercy of Krishna, we have received that mercy, right? At least theoretically we know that ISKCON moment is an ordinary moment. And we should at least try our best to perfect our life. And we have so many examples of devotees that are perfecting their lives and going back home, back to God within one lifetime. How it is possible? Who was so merciful earlier? No processes worked. But this process, Srila Prabhupada has made it so simple. Chant, practice, tolerate. Tolerate other devotees. Sometimes we have to tolerate so many things. We should have that faith that ultimately this process will work and we will be removed. That ignorance coverings will be removed. Adhik mass, we should practice. I will give a different interpretation of adhik mass. This false ego is like adhik mass. Hindi adhik mass. Mass means all the fat and everything. We should try to remove that false ego, covering of the false ego. Remove adhik mass. And it will be a pure soul. Okay, Hare Krishna. Janmashtami, Srimad Bhagvatam ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai.